and we're gonna break down this first four squared workout, which is all legs and core intensive. Your first exercise is the jump squat. So it's important when you do the jump squat that you understand the rebound effect and how you land on your toes, you land softly with your knees, you're not fully impacting your knees, so you sink down into your hips and can explode back up. So it's not a solid hard landing where you stop yourself, but it's a very fluid movement so that you can continue with that range of motion and really propel yourself off the ground. I like to do this with my hands behind my head. You can always keep your hands out in front of you and use them as momentum or on your hips. So the first thing you're gonna do is go into a deep squat, and from here, you're gonna propel yourself up using your toes and then land back on your toes and go back into that deep squat. So it's one fluid movement. So essentially here, I'm landing back on my toes so that I can propel back up. You notice that you don't hear any sound when I land. If the jumping part is too difficult for you, you can scale it back and just do body weight squats. So that's your alternative. The next exercise is the alternating rear lunge, and you'll notice that I do more of a metabolic style to this so that I'm really having less ground impact, just like my jump squat, and I'm sort of jumping between those lunges. So what you're gonna do is step one leg back, and you do want that knee to track out a little bit over the ankle. I know for years we heard that you wanna keep that shin perpendicular to the floor, but just like with our squat, if the knee travels out over the ankle, then we're really engaging all this musculature around the knee, and that's what is built to protect the knee. If you have knee pain, it's okay to keep that shin perpendicular to the floor, but you actually do want the knee to come up just a little bit toward the toe. And from here, we're gonna come up and alternate. So if you wanna speed it up a little bit, you can add a little bit of a jump. If that's too difficult for you, you can just do a stationary lunge. And then just repeat on the other side. After that, we're gonna go into our inchworm. So you're gonna stand about shoulder width apart and hinge forward. If you need to bend the knees a little bit, that's okay. If you don't have the flexibility here, you can start in a bent knee position. And from here, you're just gonna walk those hands out into a full plank, push up through the shoulder blades, squeeze the glutes, and then walk back in. Our final exercise is the tall plank climber. So from here, you're gonna come down into a plank. Make sure you squeeze those quads and glutes, push up through the shoulder blades, and you're just gonna alternate tucking the knees. And notice there's no spinal rotation here. The only thing that's moving is my legs.